Amrita Pitam, Gurmukhi, Listen and NBSP, Help Info, August 31, 1919 and NBSP, October 31, 2005, was an Indian novelist, essayist, and poet, who wrote in Punjabi and Hindi. She is considered the first prominent female Punjabi poet, novelist, essayist, and the leading 20th century poet of the Punjabi language, who is equally loved on both sides of the India-Pakistan border. With a career spanning over six decades, she produced over 100 books of poetry, fiction, biographies, essays, a collection of Punjabi folk songs and an autobiography that were translated into several Indian and foreign languages. She is most remembered for her poignant poem, aakhaan Waris Shah Nu, Today I Invoke Waris Shah Ode to Waris Shah, an elegy to the 18th century Punjabi poet, an expression of her anguish over massacres during the partition of India. As a novelist, her most noted work was Pinjar, The Skeleton, 1950, in which she created her memorable character, Puro, an epitome of violence against women, loss of humanity and ultimate surrender to existential fate. The novel was made into an award-winning film, Pinjar, in 2003. When India was partitioned into the independent states of India and Pakistan in 1947, she migrated from Lahore to India, though she remained equally popular in Pakistan throughout her life, as compared to her contemporaries like Mohan Singh and Shiv Kumar Batalvi. Known as the most important voice for the women in Punjabi literature, in 1966, she became the first woman to win the Sahitya Akademi Award for her magnum opus, a long poem, Suni Haid, Messages. Later she received the Bharatiya Jnanpith, one of India's highest literary awards, in 1982 for Kagaz Te Canvas, The Paper and the Canvas. The Padma Shri came her way in 1969 and finally, Padma Vibhushan, India's second highest civilian award, in 2004, and in the same year she was honored with India's highest literary award, given by the Sahitya Akademi, India's Academy of Letters, the Sahitya Akademi Fellowship given to the Immortals of Literature for Lifetime Achievement. Biography. Background. Amrita Pitam was born as Amrit Kaur in 1919 in Mandi Bahauddin, Punjab, in present-day Pakistan, the only child of Raj Bibi, who was a school teacher, and Karta Singh Hitkari, who was a poet, a scholar of Braj Bhasha, and the editor edited a literary journal. Besides this, he was a Pracharak and NBSP, a preacher of the Sikh faith. Amrita's mother died when she was 11. Soon after, she and her father moved to Lahore, where she lived till her migration to India in 1947. Confronting adult responsibilities and besieged by loneliness following her mother's death, she began to write at an early age. Her first anthology of poems, Amrit Laran, Immortal Waves, was published in 1936, at age 16, the year she married Pritam Singh, an editor to whom she was engaged in early childhood, and changed her name from Amrit Kaur to Amrita Pitam. Half a dozen collections of poems were to follow between 1936 and 1943. Though she began her journey as romantic poet, soon she shifted gears, and became part of the progressive writers movement, and its effect was seen in her collection, Lokpeed, People's Anguish, 1944, which openly criticized the war-torn economy, after the Bengal famine of 1943. She was also involved in social work to a certain extent and participated in such activities wholeheartedly, after independence when social activist Guru Radha Kishan took the initiative to bring the first Janta Library in Delhi, which was inaugurated by Balraj Sahni and Aruna Asaf Ali, and contributed to the occasion accordingly. This study center cum library is still running at Clock Tower, Delhi. She also worked at Lahore radio station for a while, before the partition of India. M.S. Sathyu, renowned as the director of the immortal partition movie Garam Hava, paid a theatrical tribute to her through his rare theatrical performance E.K. the Amrita. Partition of India. There were 1 million people, Muslims, Hindus and Sikhs died from communal violence that followed the partition of India in 1947, and left Amrita Pitam a Punjabi refugee at age 28, when she left Lahore and moved to New Delhi. Subsequently, in 1948, while she was pregnant with her son, and traveling from Dehradun to Delhi, she expressed anguish on a piece of paper like the poem, Aakhaan Waris Shah Nu, I Ask Waris Shah Today. This poem was to later immortalize her and become the most poignant reminder of the horrors of partition. The poem addressed to the Sufi poet Waris Shah, author of the tragic saga of Hir and Ranja and with whom she shares her birthplace. Amrita Pritam worked until 1961 in the Punjabi service of All India Radio, Delhi. After her divorce in 1960, her work became more feminist. Many of her stories and poems drew on the unhappy experience of her marriage. A number of her works have been translated into English, French, Danish, Japanese, Mandarin, and other languages from Punjabi and Urdu, including her autobiographical works Black Rose and Raza Di Ticket, Revenue Stamp. The first of Amrita Pritam's books to be filmed was Dhardi Sagar Te Sipiyan, as Kadam Berry, 1965, followed by Unadi Kahani, as Deku, Dacoit, 1976, directed by Basu Bhattacharya. Her novel Pinjar, The Skeleton, 1970, narrates the story of partition riots along with the crisis of women who suffered during the times. It was made into an award-winning Hindi movie by Chandra Prakash Dwivedi. Because of its humanism, Amritaji has portrayed the suffering of people of both the countries. Pinjar was shot in a border region of Rajasthan and Punjab. She edited Nagmani, a monthly literary magazine in Punjabi for several years, which she ran together with Imraz, for 33 years, though after partition she wrote prolifically in Hindi as well. Later in life, she turned to Osho and wrote introductions for several books of Osho, including E.K. Onkar Satnam, and also started writing on spiritual themes and dreams, producing works like Kal Chetna, Time Consciousness, and Agit Kani Mantran, Call of the Unknown. She had also published autobiographies, titled, Kala Gulab, Black Rose, 1968, Raza Di Ticket, The Revenue Stamp, 1976, and Aksharan K.C.E., Shadows of Words. Acclaim. Amrita is the first recipient of Punjab Ratan Award conferred upon her by Punjab Chief Minister Captain Amarinder Singh. She is first woman recipient of the Sahitya Akademi Award in 1956 for Suni Hai Day, poetic diminutive of the word Suni i.e. messages. Amrita Pritam received the Bhartiya Jnanpith Award, India's highest literary award, in 1982 for Kagaj Te Canvas, Paper and Canvas. She received the Padma Shri, 1969, and Padma Vibhushan, India's second highest civilian award, and Sahitya Akademi Fellowship, India's highest literary award, also in 2004. She received Doctor of Arts and Letters honorary degrees from many universities, including Delhi University, 1973, Jabalpur University, 1973, and Vishva Bharati, 1987. She also received the International Vaptsarav Award from the Republic of Bulgaria, 1979, and degree of Officer d'Ens, Ordre des Arts et des Lettres, OFFICIER, by the French government, 1987. She was nominated as a member of Rajya Sava 1986-92. Towards the end of her life, she was awarded by Pakistan's Punjabi Academy, to which she had remarked, Bade Dino Bad Mir Make Ko Mary Yad Ayi. My motherland has remembered me after a long time, and also Punjabi poets of Pakistan, sent her a chatter, from the tombs of Waris Shah, and fellow Sufi mystic poets Buhl Shah and Sultan Bahu. Personal life. In 1935, Amrita married Pritam Singh, son of a leading hosiery merchant of Lahore's Anarkali Bazaar. In 1960, Amrita Pritam left her husband. She is also said to have an unrequited affection for poet Sahir Ludhianvi. The story of this love is depicted in her autobiography, Raza Di Ticket, Revenue Stamp. When another woman, singer Sudha Malhotra, came into Sahir's life, Amrita found solace in the companionship of the renowned artist and writer Imraz. She spent the last 40 years of her life with Imraz, who also designed most of her book covers and made her the subject of his several paintings. Their life together is also the subject of a book, Amrita Imraz, A love story. N.B. She died in her sleep on October 31, 2005 at the age of 86 in New Delhi, after a long illness. She was survived by her partner Imraz, daughter Candela, son Navraj Quatra, daughter-in-law Alka, and her grandchildren, Taurus, Noor, Aman and Shilpi. Navraj Quatra was killed in 2012. Legacy. In 2007, an audio album titled, Amrita recited by Gulzar was released by noted lyricist Gulzar, with poems of Amrita Pritam recited by him. A film on her life is also on the anvil. On August 31, 2019, Google honored her by commemorating her 100th birth anniversary with a doodle. The accompanying write-up read as, Today's doodle celebrates Amrita Pritam, one of history's foremost female Punjabi writers, who dared to live the life she imagines. Born in Gujranwala, British India, 100 years ago today, Pritam published her first collection of verse at age 16. Bibliography. In her career spanning over six decades, she penned 28 novels, 18 anthologies of prose, 5 short stories and 16 miscellaneous prose volumes. Novel. Pinjar. Dr. Dev. Kora Kagaz, Unchas Din. Dhardi, Sagar or Sepian. Rang Ka Pata. Dili Ki Galleon. Tarawan Sarai. Yaatri. Jilavadan, 1968. Hardet Ka Zindaginama. Autobiography. Black Rose, 1968. Raise a Die Ticket, 1976. Shadows of Words, 2004. Short Stories. Kahaniyan Jo Kahaniyan Nahi. Kahaniyan Ke Angan Main. Stench of Kerosene. Poetry Anthologies. Amrit Lehran, Immortal Waves, 1936. Jundajewan, The Exuberant Life, 1939. Trolldote Fuel, 1942. Ojitan Valia, 1942. Bad Lambda Lalai, 1943. Sanyata Lalai, 1943. Lok Pira, The People's Anguish, 1944. Patar Gidi, The Pebbles, 1946. Punjab Dia Awaz, 1952. Suni Haid, Messages, 1955, Sahitya Akademi Award. Ashoka Kedi, 1957. Kasturi, 1957. Nagmani, 1964. Ikesai Anita, 1964. Choknambar Chatti, 1964. Aninja Din, 49 Days, 1979. Kagaz Te Canvas, 1981, Bhartiya Jnanpith. Chinnaihawi Kavitan. E.K. Bate. Literary Journal. Nagmani, Poetry Monthly.